My first audition was I sang Where Is Love from Oliver in the local church in front of like loads of like other people who did drama in the local area and a really kind lady who then, you know, said, would you like to come and play Tiny Tim? And I was tiny.
Oh, how old were you?
I was really young. I was about 7, I think. So it was a bit of, it was a bit of a stroke of luck. I got sort of like picked out of the group, and then
What should any of you?
You're to marry him,
Nigel.
I had to find your husband, sister. Now, be grateful it is done. It should be just as easy for you to fall in love with Lord Burbrook as with anyone else.
I will not hear of this.
So my first audition, I think I was about 11, and it was to play Lyra in The Golden Compass. And I think it was just like an open call. I don't actually know how I ended up auditioning for it, but I just remember being in a room with loads of other tiny girls, and we were all sort of like shouting and playing, messing around, and nothing was actually happening. And then slowly we'd get sort of picked out one by one, like, you stay, you can go.
Pretty savage, isn't it?
It was quite savage. But I remember I got picked out once and I was like, oh, I get to stay. And then, and then it didn't. I mean, I obviously didn't get the part in the end, but it was a good first experience, I guess, as an audition goes. Yeah, my first on-screen kiss was on Waterloo Road. I was 14 and I remember the boy was like a few years older than me. So I was kind of like nervous and really good looking. So I was really nervous about kissing him. And I got the sense that he was felt really awkward about kissing me, because he was like, you know, that amount of years when you're a teenager, it feels like quite a big jump. I think he was like 18. So yeah, I remember that I was quite nervous about that.
Yeah, I was playing a farmhand and I had a wig and I was supposed to look like Aragorn from Lord of the Rings, and she had like this obsession, the character. She was young, so it was probably the same amount of difference in years. She was about 13, I think, and I was about 17. And she was obsessed with Aragorn. So I had this wig and it was all like elastic banded in. So I sort of had permanently like raised eyebrows. And I remember we just had different flavour chewing gums and we sort of, I mean, it was a bit weird really. But I remember being really nervous because it is, you know, as we know, I think having done Bridgerton, now we've got intimacy coordinators, so everything's a lot easier.
Yeah. I was really overwhelmed when I read the first script for Bridgerton. I wasn't sure. Well, firstly, I was like, okay, this is my dream role, so that obviously means I'm not going to get it because things don't often work out so well. Yeah, I just remember being like, oh wow, this is amazing, because I read the script before the books. So I read the book after I read the first script. So that was sort of my first look at the story and these amazing characters. And I remember sort of just being really excited about the Bridgerton dynamic, the family dynamic, and the love story. That there's so many love stories that sort of goes on in the show, you know, the love story even between Anthony and Daphne, which is complicated. But I just remember being really overwhelmed by how brilliantly it was written and how exciting the characters were. And I knew I had to play Daphne.
Yeah, I read it. The first time I read it, I'd met everyone at Shondaland and I went in to have a meeting and we talked about Simon, and I recorded some scenes reading Simon, which is kind of like completely bizarre to think about now. And they just said in the meeting, they're like, what about Anthony? And they said, look, we're going to send you a couple of episodes and have a little read and see what you think. And I was going to Coachella Music Festival as soon as I left.
Woo!
And they sent it through. And
there's a
shout out. That was the Ariana Grande. I was there when the lemon got thrown. Terrible.
You know.
Wasn't me. And there's a massive queue to get to Coachella, and so I had three episodes to flick through, and of course you know, just right back at you what you said. I think the thing that I found really interesting is that it's all about identity in a way, and you know, having to understand who you are within a really complex social structure, and then also you can only really love until you know yourself and love yourself. And so I think for the all the characters it's brilliant, but for Anthony the idea of like toxic masculinity and that, and how incredibly bruised he is, and you know, he wants to do the best he can do, but he's just not equipped. So that seemed to ping out. And yeah, it was a no-brainer. I think when you go into a show like this, you want to make sure that the characters are people that you can like, you know, play around with for a long time, hopefully. And all of the characters, and you know, however big or small, whether they're part of the Bridgertons or not, I think are that complex that everyone, you know, has a really good time exploring them. And really wanted to be a pilot and talked about it quite a lot. And it's only sort of in the last 5 years I realised it's probably not the dream job at all, is it? Because you don't really get to travel that much, and presumably they get to see friends and family. But yeah, I did quite like the idea. I was fascinated with sort of aviation.
Did you ever go into the cockpit?
I did. Back in the early 90s when that was an okay thing to do. Obviously, that was terrifying, the idea of someone going to the cockpit. But I did, and also my uncle flew, and he was always a bit of a hero of mine because I always got told growing up, I loved tomato soup and rice pudding. And Uncle Mike also loved the two, so I sort of modelled myself on him. He was my hero.
When I was really small, I wanted to be a wedding dress designer. I really, really vividly remember, like, I would sketch, like, little sketches of wedding dresses. And I, you know, I told my mum, I was like, I'm going to be a really brilliant wedding dress designer. And they were all, like, very beautifully sort of cinched in at the waist, and they would go out. I mean, I think I still have some somewhere. But yeah, it was a very short-lived period, though. I think it was, like, 3 months.
It could be Tina from Heartbreak High or Prince Eric.
I never saw that show.
Prince Eric from The Little Mermaid. He got me going.
Interesting choice. Why Prince Eric?
Big green eyes, blue eyes? I think blue. Ariel was sort of aspirational, and Eric was just like, you know, the end point. He was the guy on land, right? It felt like a metaphor for my youth.
I think I remember mine being Peter Pan. Do you remember the live action Peter Pan? Yeah,
Kevin Costner.
Is that his name? I don't know his name.
Oh, was he in it?
No.
Oh, Kevin Costner. Bruce Willis.
the boy who played Peter Pan.
Oh, Jeremy Stumpter. Jeremy Stumpter.
No, it wasn't. It was Hook.
Hook. Was it Hook? Yeah.
The little boy. And I really remember being, I was like really in love with him.